Hey guys, it's TownieSimBuilds here, and welcome back to another build. Today's build is actually one that you guys voted for in my community tab poll, and it is in fact the Japanese-inspired karaoke bar. So apart from the karaoke bar itself, this lot did expand into a full-on Tokyo-inspired street, so hopefully it does make for a very cool night-on-the-town experience for your favorite Sims. So with that said, let's head on over to the world of Mount Komorebi and check out the build. Alright guys, and here we are with a full view of the lot. As promised, we are in fact in the world of Snowy Escape, aka Mount Komorebi, and overall this lot size is actually very small. This is a 20 by 15 lot, and it is located adjacent to the park that shipped with the world itself. Now, when I started this design, I originally was just going to do the karaoke bar, but once I was building, I thought, hey, you know, there is a lot of real estate even in this really small space. So I turned this into a Tokyo-inspired street, which does have a traditional noodle shop and also a yoga studio. Towards the back, there are also some additional spaces that your Sims can explore. So I created a little garden area with a chess table. And preferably, I would have liked to have shogi, but unfortunately, chess is the closest thing I could find in The Sims 4. But we do have a sitting area towards the back of the kitchen, and also a vending machine station as well. So if you don't feel like you want to eat at the noodle shop, you can grab a quick bite there. And of course, that is just the side of the karaoke bar, which makes full use of the city living signage as well. Anyways, moving back out, we will check out the lot in different forms of lighting. We're currently in the nighttime view here. Going now to the morning view. Onto the afternoon. Next is the evening view. And finally back to the night view, where we will take a look inside. So starting off our tour today is the first floor of the build. And we do have three different venues to look at, but we will begin with the karaoke bar itself. Now, this may look familiar if you guys saw the update in my community tab, but this is the lounge area in front of the main stage. For this area, I used a lot of city living and Snowy Escape, and overall, I wanted it to be kind of eclectic, but also very neon and colorful. You can see I did use some of the city living light fixtures as possible wall dividers, and then sectioning off this really tiny base game bar as well. So it's perfect if Sims are stopping by, they want to grab a drink, and listen to some potentially good or potentially bad singing. Yes, that is definitely the main attraction. I did squeeze in a little sink and apron area for the mixologist as well. But anyways, spinning it back around is the main stage itself. This does use the largest karaoke station, I do believe, that is in City Living, along with the base game lights as well, just for some proper staging and some light effects. So pretty cool area, I have seen a lot of Sims make use of that. And if your Sims are feeling a little bit peckish, we do have an outdoor traditional noodle or ramen shop, which was inspired by both real-life examples and also anime, surprisingly. We do have the traditional Noren banners there, just to offer your Sims a little bit of privacy. And the shop itself is comprised of both the bar and the bar decal from the Snowy Escape pack. So unfortunately, there wasn't a lot of room for other items, but I did squeeze in some aprons, a trash can, and then also some food imagery inside of the decal itself. So it is hidden in there, I promise. But anyways, moving back is the industrial kitchen. Now, in terms of your mixologists, I don't believe they're going to be using this space, but it is here as a realistic detail. It is fully equipped with a fridge, sink, dishwasher, two stoves, and also a smoke detector for good measure. Moving on back, keeping with that realism, we do have a little tiny backyard space, so if possible employees want to take a break, that's definitely a great place to do so. And of course, we have some two outdoor trash cans as well. Unfortunately, I had some Sims kicking them over, and it is a little bit obtrusive, but it is a fun little detail nonetheless. Anyways, on the corner, we do have a look at our yoga studio. And this space, you guys, went through a lot of variations. I originally wanted to do a Japanese-inspired arcade, but I didn't want the karaoke bar to be overshadowed. So anyways, here we are on the inside. This is the check-in counter or receptionist area. If you do want to schedule a class or join a class, if you will, this is a great place to do so. And we do have one of the lockers from Snowy Escape as well. Going a little farther back before you enter the classroom area, we do have some very narrow bathrooms that fortunately were made possible by Snowy Escape. So it's not very realistic, it's not conventional, but there is a sink, shower, and toilet in each one. And of course, the rooms are gender neutral. Anyways, this is just a look at the staircase going up with a little bit of spa day details in there as well. Completing our tour today is the second floor of the build. And this floor has a lot of very interesting spaces that are tied to the venues below. Starting us off is the second floor of the karaoke bar. And honestly, I had a lot of fun referencing real life examples. So generally in Japan, if you go to a karaoke bar, it is very common to see actual individualized rooms. So if you have some friends or maybe a larger group, you can actually go into one of these rooms and have a more private karaoke experience. And yeah, they were really fun, you guys. The rooms were very colorful. They had a lot of light effects. The karaoke units themselves are very advanced. They have a lot of songs from different years, languages, genres, if you will. And you can even order food, sort of like appetizers, from the rooms themselves. So you will see a lot of different food posters and menus that I placed in these rooms. And I tried to create a very sort of antiquated speaker system. It's probably more high tech in the real location, but you can see that there with the little light switch and the speaker from Spa Day, just to kind of simulate that real life detail. But yeah, it's definitely a lot of fun watching Sims come up here. I've definitely seen some townies come over, try out the karaoke stand studios. And of course, what we're looking at is the larger room of the three. So it does have a TV in the back. Unfortunately, the TV doesn't coordinate with special music videos, but I thought it was a nice detail to have. But yes, here they are. You can definitely find a lot of real life locations that have a lot of the same details as the ones I tried to incorporate in this build. But anyways, moving on over, if you're not into music, dancing, and singing, we do have the full-on yoga studio here. If you like to relax and unwind, this is the second floor. You can see that this is the entrance area. We do have another locker towards the left, and also a rack from Snowy Escape. Just if you want to hang your coat, your scarf, your jacket, if it's a little chilly outside in Mount Komorebi, that is the place to do so. And then entering the studio itself, we do have the instructor's area. So this room had to be quite large. I actually kind of ate into the noodle shop area, if you will, so this kind of merged to the second floor. But overall, I had a lot of fun designing this space. I did want to keep some traditional elements with some of the tatami mats, a little bit of the sort of shoji screen windows and inspired wood paneling there. But we do have some additional yoga mats with a music player and then some artwork along the walls as well, in addition to the bamboo plants from Spa Day. As you can clearly tell, Spa Day was essential with creating this area, and I really enjoy designing with both Spa Day and the objects from the Snowy Escape pack, given that they work so well together. So looking at the lot specs as a whole, this is in fact a 20 by 15 lot. So it is very small, it can definitely fit into a lot of lots within Mount Komorebi, and also lots outside of this world as well. The lot type is of course set to a karaoke bar. So if your Sims want to hang out, grab a drink, and possibly try their hand at music, this is definitely the perfect place to do so. Now alternatively, I do believe you can also set this to a bar or lounge, whatever you prefer within your game. In terms of packs, this of course still uses base game, but we do stick to our 4-pack limit. This build uses objects from Get Together, City Living, Snowy Escape, and the Spa Day game pack. Alright guys, and that is a wrap on the Tokyo-inspired karaoke street. First off, I want to thank all of you guys for voting in my polls. I really enjoy what you guys pick for our monthly build. And if you guys do like more builds like this, if you love more nightlife venues, or perhaps you like more builds themed around Japan, definitely feel free to let me know in the comments below. On another note, we will have another Build of the Month poll up very soon, so definitely keep your eyes peeled for the community tab. And as always, this has been TownieSimBuilds, signing off. Thank you so much for watching, guys.